Good morning. How are you guys? I had a hard time waking up this morning, I'm not gonna lie. My poor husband is like super sick and has been coughing like nonstop. So that was fun, but he seems to be feeling better, so hopefully tonight will be a little bit better. But yeah, I'm glad to be here and I'm glad you guys are here. Nice to see you. You guys have a good weekend. Yeah, hopefully a good weekend. I had a busy weekend, but not in a good way. Mostly like cleaning and not fun stuff, but this weekend should be good. All right. Okay, so today I have glute-focused legs, and then I'm going to do some abs. I think I got cable reverse crunch. That's the new one, and I think you guys have seen some of the hanging abs. I'm going to do some of those today as well. So what I have today, I'm going to do some body weight squats for my warm up, and then I'm going to do some dynamic stretches, show you guys a couple of those before I get started lifting. So the reason I do dynamic stretching at the beginning of my workout is just to keep your muscles shorter. The length, when you do static stretching, it lengthens your muscles, so you're not going to have as much power. It's really good for flexibility though, so I do do the static stretching afterward, but if you're going to be trying to lift heavy weights or do any kind of explosive movements like box jumps, anything like that, you're going to want to warm up with dynamic stretching. And if you're an athlete, you're going to live on dynamic stretching and then do the static stretching at the end. So but yeah, stretching is perfect for muscle growth and recovery and just injury prevention. So make sure you guys stretch. I know I'm lazy when it comes to stretching sometimes, but it is so important. Good morning, Marky Mark. Good to see you again. What is that? Left debauchery. Thanks for the follow. Awesome. Okay. Hey, Marky Mark, did you have a good weekend? Did you get my email? I sent an email over, I think. I'm not the most tech savvy person, so yeah. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead. Okay. Yeah, I know, right? Followage. I made it to my goal now, yeah. So my next goal is 1,000. It's gonna take me longer than 3 or 4 days to get to that one, but you know, that's okay. I'm hopeful. Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and start my bodyweight squats for my warm-up. I'm probably gonna do about 3 sets of 20, and then that should hopefully help me break a sweat. So we're gonna start there. Hey, there's one set. Okay. Yeah, I did work on making the changes today. Awesome. Marky Mark, have you done any of the workouts yet? Have you tested the waters with them? What do you think? Any feedback? What are the best warm-ups before squatting? What is that? Baby Yaga? Okay, so whenever I do any kind of squat workout, I obviously like to do similar movements to what I'm about to do. So if I'm gonna squat, I like to do bodyweight squats. So I definitely will do bodyweight squats and anything that warms up like your hips. So like I did bench step overs on the last stream. I'm not sure if you were there the last leg day. I think it might have been Friday. It was either Friday or Wednesday. I can't remember, but I did bench step overs and that was a really good one. And I'll do like fire hydrants if you guys know what those are. I can show you those real quick before I start. So bench step overs is really good to warm up your hips. Put one leg on and then you step up and over while the same leg stays on the bench. And this warms up kind of your outer hip. It warms up your quads and it warms up your glutes. So it's a really good warm up for any kind of squat. And you'll do that on both legs. Another one for leg days that I typically do, I'll do some kind of kickback or hamstring curl to warm up my hamstrings. And then I'll do, let me see, can you guys see me here? I'll do fire hydrants where I'll put a band around my knees or my ankles and I'll go up and out and warm up those abductors, just like that. And I'll do that on both sides. So yeah, that's probably my best workout for legs, especially squats. And that activates your glutes, kind of warms up quads, hamstrings, glutes, all that, and your abductors. Okay, so I'm gonna do another set of bodyweight squats real quick. Set two. I'm still drinking coffee. I'm a bad influence. I'm drinking water too, if that makes it any better. Welcome in, friends. I'm glad you're here. Baby Yaga, thanks for the follow. Last set of 20. Okay, there's three sets of 20 bodyweight squats. All right. You guys doing anything fun this weekend? I am supposed to go over to my mother's house for Easter dinner. We're thinking about taking my son to go see that new Mario movie that's coming out. It's his first movie. He's just about to turn four. And I'm hoping that it's not too early to take him to the movies, but it might be. So we'll see how that goes. If he's gonna sit through any movie, it's gonna be this one. So we'll cross our fingers, get him some candy and popcorn, sugar him up. All right. Okay, so the next thing I'm gonna do is some dynamic stretches. And this is just gonna stretch out kind of our hips and hips, quads, and all that. Are you new to fitness content? I am Baby Yaga. I am new to streaming, but not new to fitness. I've been doing fitness for a long time, been a personal trainer for a while. And yes, I'm new to streaming fitness content, yes. But yeah. I'm gonna switch over views on my camera real quick so you guys can actually see me. Let's see if this will work. No, that just didn't do anything, did it? Okay. Cardio? There it goes, okay. So I'm gonna use my treadmill to hold on to while I do these. Okay. So I'm doing some lateral leg swings. And this helps stretch out your groin, adductors, and just loosens up your hips. I feel a little bit of hamstring in there as well. Okay. And I do about two sets of each one on each leg. Okay. And then I'm going to do some front leg swings. And this gets your hip flexors and your quads and your hamstrings. So you're pretty much good to go after doing these. Okay. Okay, and we're going to do one more set of each of those. Lateral again, or the front raises, I'm sorry. Okay, and the other side. All right, feel pretty warm. Let me switch over main shot. There we go. Okay, cool. So those are the two that I definitely do before leg day, and I love it. Oh, let's see. Danny Vegas. Oh, and setup. Yeah, I love the setup. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that. That's very sweet. Thanks. I'm working on the physique. But yeah, thank you. I appreciate it. Good work. Thank you. Oh, you're a Twitch streamer as well? That's awesome. What's your name? Is your name Danny Vegas? Your Twitch stream as well? Or what's your name? Let's see. The King of Velcro. Hi. Is that, what's his name? Oh gosh, the King of Velcro. David? King of Velcro, is your name David? Okay. All right, so the first workout I have today, now that I'm warmed up, is gonna be, it's gonna be a single leg RDL. Last week we did double leg barbell RDLs, and I like to go back and forth between doing single leg stuff and barbell. Barbell, you can usually add more weight. Barbell, you can add more weight, and single leg helps with making sure that both legs are equally strong, and helps with your body balance and all that. I was a hurdler, so my left hip is super flexible and my right hip is not, so I am I've been working on that for a while now, trying to get that imbalance fixed. But you know, yeah. Yes, it's Daniel. Oh my gosh, that is so funny. Yeah, I still need to post that belt Velcro video. I need to actually figure out. I haven't even figured out if I have my TikTok up and running yet. I've been slammed lately. We've been incredibly busy whenever I'm not streaming. So today, hopefully it will be. I got most of my crap done yesterday, so I'm hoping that today I'll get a little bit of time. But I need to look at my TikTok before I forget. So yeah, I'm still thinking about that. I'm gonna post that for you. I'm on your YouTube, but I don't think you can see it again. I don't know why I'm on. Oh, let's see, multi-stream. Was I just on Twitch? Yeah, something's wrong with the multi-stream. Whenever I go click into multi-stream on the chat, it shows nothing. Like I don't see Twitch or YouTube or anything. So I have no idea what the heck's going on there, but. I do have Kick and Twitch up apparently. I don't know why my YouTube chatters aren't showing up, but we'll figure it out. But that's funny. I love your name, the King of Velcro. That's hilarious. You are doing great. Oh, thank you, Danny Vegas. You are very sweet. And your Twitch, Danny Vegas. I'm definitely going to go check out your stream and hopefully learn some stuff from your streaming. I'm still very new to this, so I have a lot to learn. But I really appreciate the support, and I plan on supporting you back. And all my other friends should support Danny Vegas, too. Okay, I'm going to go do these single leg RDLs. I do it with a kettlebell. I think, let me see. It's 24 kg, whatever that is, weight-wise, I'm not sure. But it feels heavy, so I'm doing that. And I do it elevated, too, so I can get more range of motion and really feel that stretch in my hamstrings. So I'm not sure how much you can see on this main screen, but on my second shot, you should be able to see me just fine. All right, I'll be right back. Okay, I use this box to help me balance a little bit, but I try not to put too much pressure on there because I want to make sure that my working hamstring is learning how to balance as well, really working. That was spicy. Oh man. This is really good for isolating your hamstring. I'd say more so even than the barbell RDLs. You can also do this with a dumbbell if you don't have access to a kettlebell. Not gonna lie, those are terrible. Let's see. That's okay. Yeah, the YouTube, David, the YouTube has been kind of not working as well. It was kind of glitchy too when I went up there, when I was looking at the videos one of the days too. So I'll have my guy look at it, see what's going on. You go to gym. I was also in your last stream too. Thank you. I appreciate the support. I was hoping that you guys heard me say that I knew you guys were out there. I just knew something was wrong with the chat. But yeah. I'm glad you found me on Kick. That's good. All right. Okay, so I really only want to do three sets of those, but I'm going to do four. Usually the first set I end up doing more reps because my hamstrings are so fresh. And then I, oh, look at Yoki's taking a nap. Little cutie. I end up doing more on the first set and then, oh shoot, no, I didn't find the belly band. I think it's in storage up in my attic somewhere, but I also have like 100 boxes up there, so yeah, I'm planning on going up there soon. I need to get some of my spring stuff out. I still have a Christmas mat on my front door, and it's April, so if that tells you, you have to go pet him. How do I do that? Nostradamus, how do I pet him? Okay. Were you able to find? Yeah, I'll look. I need to figure out the TikTok and look for that belly band today. I need to write a note so I don't forget. I have a sticky pad. Okay. TikTok. I can't spell TikTok. Is it T? Okay, sure, we'll do that. I think that's right. I'm also horrible at spelling, so these fun, little fun facts about me. I love coffee, I love food, can't spell. Let's see, I said TikTok, oh yeah, and belly band. Belly band, awesome, okay. Well, now I shouldn't forget, because I actually have a note. Welcome, Nostradamus. Yeah, that's okay, no worries. Yeah, my littlest one hasn't been taking a afternoon nap, and I normally get all my stuff done then, so, because he's taking a nap when I stream, and then the afternoon nap is when I get all my cleaning and emails and looking for my belly band kind of stuff, so yeah. The King of Velcro, thanks for the follow on Kick. Okay, I'm gonna go do another set real quick and then hopefully not die. Got my handy dandy chalk. Woohoo! That was fun. Oh, goodness. All right. Somehow managed to do 15 on that one too. Must have been a Patty Cathy. Oh, that Doc Steel Hammer. Thanks for the follow. Okay, I'm kind of dying. Oh, Pando. Get him. So cute. So. All right. Oh, your name's Daniel, not David. Oh my gosh. Okay. So I knew, I was close. Close enough. Close enough. Daniel. His name is Daniel. Oh my gosh. That's funny. I knew it started with a D. D-A something. You know, funny story. When I first met, who is now my husband, I kept calling him the wrong name. And I could not, like, it was like his name starts with a C. So every name that started with a C, I would just interchange it with that one because I could not, like, to save my life, remember this guy's name. And then, what's it called? I also didn't like him. I thought he was super douchey. I was like, oh, this guy. And then after a while, because I didn't like him, once I actually learned his name, because he corrected me so many times, I like purposely called him the wrong name just to irritate him. And it kind of turned into a game. So I thought that was funny. Daniel, Daniel, Daniel. Okay, Daniel, your name is Daniel. I got it. So I think everybody should wear name tags all the time because I can never remember people's names. So that's just a little silly thing about me. I'd probably forget my own name, but yeah. Sorry about that, Daniel. I'm gonna accidentally call you David all the time now because in my head you're gonna be David. Okay, that's funny. Welcome to the chat, guys. Is my multi-stream still gone? Yeah. All right. Well, if I have any YouTubers out there, I see you, but I don't see you. I don't see you, but I know you're there. However many of you there are, I love you guys. Okay, I'm gonna go do my third set real quick. My hands are super sweaty, as usual. Okay, here we go. I should do my weaker leg first because my right leg always gets 15 and I struggle so bad on my left leg. And my heart rate's elevated too, so I guess that probably has something to do with it. Daniel, you even said it in the chat. My name. No, you don't have to do that. The King of Velcro. I like that name. That's pretty funny. Don't change your name on my behalf. My name should have been like Coffee Lover or something. Star Wars nerd. All right, I think that was set three. I think I got one more. One more set. I'm about to kick on the fan. I'm hungry. Little panda, look at he's crying. Or Yoki. Poor there. Look at him. Oh, poor thing. All right, me too, bud. A name related to Velcro, yeah. I think that's totally appropriate. The king of Velcro, that's great. What's your, you'll have to tell me what your TikTok name is so I can tag you, or is that how that works on TikTok? I don't know. I haven't used TikTok in such a long time. Can I tag you on TikTok? Somebody help. Okay. I'm gonna go do that last set and get it over with. I love those so much, but it's a love-hate relationship because they are so horrible. But you guys should totally do them. They're great. Great for your hamstring. All right, I'll be right back. Okay. Be good for that. All my little reminders. You said you were a track star, right? I mean, I wouldn't say a track star, but I did, yeah, I ran track. I was a multi, so I did 7 events in 2 days. And ew, that face, is that Borat? Looks like Borat. WC3. Welcome in. It's good to have you back. Yeah, so I did the heptathlon is what it's called. I did 4 events on my first day and 4 events on the, yeah, I competed in college, yes. I went to D1. I got a full ride scholarship actually for throwing javelin, but I also did the heptathlon too, and that's one of the events in the heptathlon, so... I did that. I competed in community college in California for 2 years, and then my second 2 years were full ride to somewhere in Missouri. It was some smaller. It was a smaller D1, but still, the track team there was amazing, really good. So, but not track there. So, yeah. Well, yeah. My score for the heptathlon, definitely, like I wasn't the best for the heptathlon. There was one girl that was way better than me. She like murdered me, but she could score more points if she competed in all the events individually than doing the heptathlon. So that's the only reason why I won my division. But this one girl totally spanked me. Like she was just like, she was the amazing. Georgia Ellenwood. She streams and is an Olympic heptathlete. No, I actually don't know who that is. See, I'm terrible at following professional athletes. And especially now that I don't run track anymore, whenever I watch that kind of stuff, it makes me like really sad. So I can't even watch like sports I like haven't played before. Like me watching like women's basketball or something, like it just makes me feel like, I don't know, because I guess I'm not competing anymore. It makes me feel weird watching that kind of stuff. Even watching football, like any kind of sport, if I watch it, it just makes me upset. I get like emotional, like I could be playing that right now. And it's like football, it's like, no, you can't. So yeah, I ran track and I really enjoyed it. Okay, what do we got? Gotta go, have a great workout and stream. Thank you, Baby Yaga. I hope to see you back. Appreciate you stopping in. Okay. All right, so the next one, what do I got? I got box step-ups, which are also, those are a tough one. Single leg box step-ups with dumbbells. You can do these, standing more upright is gonna do your quads more, more quad focused. And if you lean forward, it's gonna be more glute focused. So it just depends on kind of what your goals are for. You can alternate 1 week do quad focused, 1 week do glute focused, just to, if you're wanting overall overall strength, but yeah. Welcome, what is that? Ripe review. So jelly. I know, I honestly still can't believe that I have a home gym. I'm super excited about all that. So I'm right there with you. It's a dream come true. I guess once you show your support band, we'll see. That is also Velcro, yes. I'm gonna find everything in my house that has Velcro on it, and I'm gonna make just a whole bunch of like video edits of me just ripping the Velcro open and tag you in it. So yeah, that'll be funny. Have fun making that one. Okay, sorry, Marky Mark, I didn't get this message. Is my website up and running yet? It is not. We're still working on it. Like I said, we've been kind of slammed lately, trying to get everything going, but yeah, it will be up and running soon. We're going to have a website with, workouts, like different phases throughout the year. I typically do more of a bulking, weight gain muscle, like gaining lean muscle in the fall. And then I have a transition period. And then I go into like the spring shred is what I call it. And so I have all those already written. I kind of just need to get it up on my website. So, but we're working on getting that up and running. If you guys are interested, you can learn as much as you can off of these streams too. I mean, I literally do everything that I normally do. I don't know if I really keep anything out of my streams that I don't do. Shredded summer. Yeah, you got to do it in spring if you actually want a body for summer. Everybody starts in like June. They'll start working out and then be like, why am I not in shape yet? It's July and they want to be shredded, only working out for a month. So yeah, I actually start transitioning out of my my bulk December, towards the end of December. And then I do a short little transition and then I go into a spring shred. And by summertime, then, I mean, I'm exactly where I want to be. And then I can kind of go into more of a maintenance phase during summer and actually enjoy my summer. I can drink and eat and still be in really good shape. And then I go right into transition right into a bulk in the fall. Because, I mean, with all the holidays in the fall, if you try and do any kind of shredding or anything, even a maintenance in the fall is really hard to maintain your calories. So I'm like, you know what, might as well just do a surplus in the fall and, you know, let myself have that pecan pie or pecan, whatever you guys say. Pecan? Who's a pecan? Who's pecan? I said pecan pie when I was in South Carolina and they looked at me like, what is that? I'm like, how do you say it? And they say it's pecan pie. I'm like, okay, I'm sorry. Begin in March at the latest, peak shred. By the end of August, that seems so late. By August time, I'm like, I'm ready to start munching on food again. For me, summer is 9 months out of the year. Oh, you're is that Florida? Florida boy? Flex the biceps. Every time, how come you like the bicep flexing? Okay, here we go. Ready? It's not my most impressive muscle, but there you go. Hope you liked it. Okay. All right. Okay, so I'm gonna go to the restroom real quick. I'll be back in just a second. BRB. All right, I'm back. Sorry about that. I drank a whole bunch of coffee, so I've been peeing like every 5 minutes. It's bad. Okay, it's most impressive. Thank you. What is that, furious peep? Thank you. Just saying, depending on. Florida boy, or FL boy, sorry. Are you saying like shredding that long is hard, or what's your, what are you getting at there? I don't know if I misunderstood you. I usually, my transition period will be from, I'll start tracking my calories, but not change any, I won't go into a deficit until right about March, but I only do it from March until June is usually my shred phase. I start becoming more aware of what I eat. I'll start tracking my food, kind of seeing where I'm at. Because if I'm maintaining, say I'm eating 2,800 calories and I'm not gaining any weight, then I'll know, okay, you know, that's probably that's my maintenance calories. And then I'll do my shred off of that. Because even calculating the ones on the website, those are a little bit more generalized. So I go based off of where I'm at, like, because my maintenance calories used to be lower, but then I gained a whole bunch of muscle in the fall during my bulk. And so, you know, my metabolism might be higher, faster. And so my maintenance calories are going to be a little bit higher than what they used to be, because you don't want to be in too much of a deficit and stuff like that. So. But yeah, I don't actually start going into a deficit until the beginning of March. And then I do March, April, May, and then June is kind of like I'll start transitioning into a maintenance phase. So the cutting phase really isn't that long. I just I'll do a deficit, and I bump up my cardio a little bit more. I'll do like cardio accelerations in between each set, and between those two things and working out every day. I mean, it doesn't take long to see definition and get shredded. So at least for me, that works really well. Lots of videos about doing Velcro. You really are the Velcro King. I think that is your name forever. I don't even think I can call you Daniel anymore. It's going to be the Velcro King. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and start my next workout. Like I said, it's going to be dumbbell box step-ups. And I do this with a 24-inch box. So when I'm all the way down on the floor, I'm going to be in a little bit of a deficit, if that makes sense. We'll go ahead and get started with that. Can you guys see me here? Do it over here. Yeah, we'll do it right there. Okay. Be using 15s today. Grab some water real quick. So this box is a little soft, so I definitely have to use a lot of balance on this one. Keeps my ankle steady, which is really good too, I think. Just like that. And I do it slow and controlled, both up and down, because that time under tension is what's really going to help with that muscle growth. Oh, man. And the cardio. These are like major cardio, too. Okay. So, yeah, see how my leg is technically in a deficit here? It's exactly where I want to be, pushing through the heel and leaning forward, because I want mine to be glute focused. So my quads are plenty big. I just need to tighten up some on my legs. Only get 12 of those. Curious Pete, thank you so much for the follow. Appreciate you. Let's see. Right. Yeah, you're absolutely right. FL boy. Yeah. I'd rather get started early than too late. So yeah, definitely you can hear phases, depending on who you are, can be. And I know for me personally, being in a deficit is very hard for me because I am just such a hungry individual. I absolutely love food. So if I know that my cutting phase is going to be shorter, my level of success is going to be way higher. And some people like to do, you know, a smaller deficit for a longer period of time too. And that works for them too. So, I mean, it just depends on who you are and how patient you are. I like to see results fast, so I'm a little bit impatient. I can't wait to go on my first cut. I've been having a really hard time putting on muscle. You've been having a hard time putting on muscle, Furious Peep. Barely made any gains in a year's time, but I'm starting to see more progress. Okay, so when you're trying to gain muscle, you need to make sure that you're in a 10% caloric surplus from your maintenance calories. And the reason why you might not be seeing as much results with the muscle gain, it could be the problem, like weight-wise, maybe you're not hitting the correct percentage of your max, and like how many reps were you getting? Were you going for more of like an 8 to 12? Were you doing like a 5 to 8? What was your rep range? Because that makes a huge difference in gaining muscle and also being in that caloric surplus. If you're in a deficit, you can't gain muscle. It's as simple as that. You can definitely shred and your muscles will appear to look bigger. Like my shoulders will look super scrawny, and then when I start shredding and this layer starts getting thinner, my skin, then my muscles will appear to get bigger, but they're not actually bigger. So, but yeah, it depends on your calories and your weight and your reps. So, let me know kind of where you're at rep wise. And, if you're going heavier or lighter calorie wise, where are you at? Are you tracking your protein intake, making sure you're getting adequate protein for somebody your size? I mean, there's a lot of factors that could be affecting that. And I mean, it could be a program. Maybe the program that you had just didn't work for you personally. But yeah, just let me know. I'll try and help you out. Okay, let's see. Yes, you should totally do that. My TikTok name for when you do the videos is The Lover of Velcro. Okay. I'm totally making that soon, and I'm gonna tag you. Gotta be on the lookout for it. I need to make sure I have my TikTok made for this one. But yeah, I think that'd be super funny. I'd give you guys my personal TikTok, but I don't ever go on it anymore. I think I have it. I had it during COVID when everybody was posting like the best TikToks ever. It was great. And then after everybody started going back to work, then I was like, whatever, and I stopped using it. But I had some pretty embarrassing videos that were, I mean, they were funny. I like to make people laugh, so they were funny, but they were, I didn't look the cutest in them, we'll just say that. All right. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and do another set of these. Be right back. I really think the hardest part of this is just the balance. Probably be easier if you had like a wooden, like a Rogue box that are, it's solid. I got this for box jumps though, so that if for whatever reason I had to bail out, I wouldn't like cheese grate my shin. I've done that on a metal box before and got a nasty scar for it.
or at least for a while I did. I think it's a good bit of it's probably faded now. Man, those are tough. Oh man, okay, let's see. Okay, I will look out for that. I will seriously try and make that as soon as I can. I gotta do some groceries today, but a lot of my stuff's already done, so we'll be good. Okay. Florida, by the way. Florida boy. We're planning on getting a house down in Florida. We want to do a short-term rental, and then when we're not there, obviously, we'll do the short-term rental, and then when we want to go down there, we'll just book it for ourselves. So where should I go? You're from Florida? Tell me where to go. We're thinking Clearwater. How is Clearwater? Have you been there? Do you like it? Let's see. I tend to do 4x12, 12 reps as a minimum. If I can go more reps in all reps. Okay, so whenever I do a 4x12 during more of like the transition period to more of like a shred, I'll do my shred. I usually do 12 to 15 reps. Whenever I'm trying to gain muscle and size, I stick more to a 6 to 8 rep range. I do a lot of 5x5s that time of year, and I go really heavy. So whenever I'm bulking, that's kind of my rep range. I'll transition like, okay, so right now I'm in my spring shred. I'll do more cardio. I do a lot less cardio in the fall when I'm bulking because it's a little bit counterproductive to muscle growth. So I'll do like 5x5s a lot of a couple different exercises, and I'll go pretty heavy. So I'm thinking more like 85% of my max. So maybe safely establish what your maxes are at the beginning of your bulk season. And then do some 5x5 training, or, you know, 4 sets of like 5 to 8 reps, and lower the reps, increase the weight, and then have longer rests in between your sets because you're going so heavy. And whenever you do the 4x12, you do lower rests and keep that heart rate higher. That's what's going to help you shred, is keeping that heart rate high for long periods of time. So doing the cardio accelerations in between your sets is going to help you shred, keep that heart rate high. And with bulking, you want to keep the reps lower, weight higher, long rests. Like, I think I do like 2-minute rests in between when I'm bulking, and I've seen a lot of results doing that. So let's see. Tampa Bay has a lot going on. Yeah, I could see that. They have a lot there. I don't want to do Miami or anything like that because I'm just worried about kind of crime. I know it's super hot there. People love going to Miami, but I just don't know if that's exactly what I want. But yeah, Tampa Bay, we did look into Tampa Bay for a while. St. Pete, yep, we looked there for a while. And I mean, I'm okay with it being a little bit pricey if you have a short-term rental. I mean, some of these people are paying like 10 grand for a week just to stay there a week, which is crazy. And so yeah, we're trying to find something that has a lot of traffic where you can still get a decent amount coming through. Oh, yes, the Mike Mentzer. I actually don't know who that is. Furious Pete. Type of training. Heavy with great intent. Yeah. Yeah. And another part of gaining lean muscle, I do the 5x5 training a lot, or like the 4x6 to 8. And I've also done, whenever I'm going, I'll start my bulk season off with that. And then when I'm transitioning, kind of when I'm going from bulk, transitioning kind of into a maintenance, I'll do an 8x8, which is horrible. Do not recommend. I mean, I do. It's really good. It's kind of a combination. The weight is still really heavy, but the reps, the eight reps was, it's doing 8 sets of 8 reps is a lot. So there's high volume there. So I'll start my bulk season off with a like 5x5 kind of deal, and then I'll move to an 8x8. But obviously, you can't do as many workouts. So you might do like 3 or 4 workouts 8x8, but you will feel it. Like, it's rough. So that's kind of like the two phases of my bulk, 5x5 and then 8x8. And then from the 8x8, it's an easy transition over to like when you start transitioning into the spring, because you're already doing 8 reps. And then when you go to like 4 sets of 12, when you start moving into like your spring shred, then it's an easy transition. So I just try and do it, because if you go straight from a 5x5 into a shred program, it's rough. It's really rough on the cardio. You die. So I do have transition periods in between my major phases. Clearwater is very nice, 30 minutes from me. Yeah, well, if we do buy down there, we'll have to meet up. Okay, let's see. Welcome in, guys. What is that? Tainted One. Atomic Flower. Thank you guys for the follow. I appreciate it. Oh, we got flowers. What is that? Faye, thanks for the follow on Kick. Mike, thanks for the follow. Oh, I don't even know what that says. I hope that's not what I'm reading. Something, teacher. Thanks for the follow. Okay. Alrighty. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and do another set real quick. I think that's only set 3. What was that? Why is he on fire? Yeah, we do like Fort Lauderdale. Well, that's kind of what we were going back and forth, was Fort Lauderdale. And possibly Clearwater. I think the prices in Clearwater are a little bit better, so you're possibly leaning a little bit more towards that one, but we'll see. See where the road takes us. What's that? All RM, thanks for the follow. What is that? DPDA Profit, thanks for the follow. Appreciate you guys. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Okay, let's see. Aw, King of Velcro, that is so sweet. Thank you. I try really hard. There are some days I wake up, I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to look haggard today, but not saying that there are days where I won't have much makeup on. I'll just throw a hat on the days I don't feel like looking as pretty, but I really appreciate it. I try and put as much effort in as I can. Most of the time I'm trying to entertain the kids. I'm like trying to do my eyeliner and they're like grabbing my arm. I'm like, stop. But they're sweet. I really love my boys are great. Okay. Gulf Coast, Florida should always be better value. Yeah, I was going to say that the hurricanes might be better there too, but that's so not true. I think the last couple have come on the Gulf side. Sarasota. The best beach in the nation. What, the Siesta Key beach? I have never been there. I've only been to Florida once, and it was actually just recently. Well, I went to Floribama, if you have ever been there. It's right on the border. And I went at nighttime, so I didn't actually see Florida that day. But recently we went to Bonita Beach. It's right outside Naples, and that was really nice. We saw the coolest cars there. Oh my gosh. We were like, our necks were breaking. We were like looking. I was like, oh my gosh, was that this? Was that this? Like, we saw like McLarens and Lamborghinis and stuff like, and it wasn't just like the base ones. It was like an SVJ we saw, and we saw all sorts of cool cars there. So I think I enjoyed that just as much as I enjoyed like going to the beach. So that was a fun little trip. But yeah. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and do this last set and get these over with. And then we'll move on. I think I got curtsy lunges next. Here. Why is that highlighted? No. Okay. Well, oh, there we go. Okay. I want this. Okay. All right, last set. Oop. Oh my gosh. Definitely tell us in my last set. Oof. Okay.
anxiety.
Thank goodness those are over. Although, I don't think the next exercise is any easier. Yeah, I got curtsy lunges next. So I'm gonna do curtsy lunges, barbell today. I do these dumbbell too, but I've done a lot of dumbbell work today, so my forearms are, they're burning out. I could use my wrist wraps, but I guess I'm being kind of lazy. But yeah, I will be doing barbell curtsy lunges. Barbell curtsy lunges are really good if you have access to a Smith machine. That was my favorite way of doing curtsy lunges. I don't have a Smith machine, so I'm gonna just do it just barbell, and it works just as good. It's just not as convenient. So yeah, we got the king of Velcro. Thank you so much. You know, being kind is a goal I think everybody should try and do, and it's really hard sometimes. I'm not always kind, but you have no idea what kind of impact that you can make in somebody's life. And there were some times where I was having such a horrible day, and somebody was kind to me, and it was like, it made all the difference in the world. It completely turned my day around. There was one day I was having such a horrible day, and I was going through the drive-thru at Starbucks. I was like, you know what, a coffee will make me feel better, which it doesn't, but I just try and lie to myself because I was like, you know what, coffee will make me feel better. Well, the person in front of me in the car ended up paying for my order. I guess they were just trying to be nice. They had no idea who I was, and they didn't know I was having a bad day, and they just paid for my coffee. And I was having such a horrible day, and I cried in my car, and I had somebody, I mean, they have no idea like that how much of a deal that made for me that day. And sometimes people have rough days more than one day in a row. They can go months or years of having rough days, so being kind is the best. What do we got? Thank you. Yes, you do put a smile on my face. You are so sweet. Yoki's saying hi. That little dancing emoji is super funny. Look at it. Is it an alien? If it is, that would make it so much better. Oh my gosh, it is an alien. That's so funny. I love that. Oh my goodness. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and set up my curtsy lunges. Be right back. I'm going to regret using safety bars, but they could kind of get in the way for curtsy lunges. But if my legs start feeling like they're going to give out, at least I have a little bit of peace of mind. My legs are definitely feeling fatigued from all the single leg stuff today. What do we got? Round two. Try 15. I'm sick of hearing you say sorry. And all of your crimes. What is that, Chino? I'm probably butchering that, but thank you for the follow. What is that? Nut 1212. Thanks for the follow. What did he say? So true. Always good to be kind to others. Yeah. So true.
So true.
Gotta love people. People are great. Yeah, and usually if people are being mean, happy people aren't mean. Happy people don't say hurtful things. So when people are nasty to me, I just think that I don't know what's going on in their life, and they're unhappy, and that's kind of sad. So always keep that into perspective, because like I said, happy people don't try and hurt other people. So next time you get mad at somebody, just remember that. Okay. I'm probably most definitely going to hit these safety bars, because you have to be in like the perfect position, doing curtsy lunges not to. So yeah, it's gonna feel awkward, but it's fine. All right, ready to go.
Oh man,
can't pop yawning today. Okay, what is that? Contributing VUPO. Thank you for the follow. I appreciate it. You guys doing okay? Having a good day? Anybody got fun plans this weekend? Okay, so I went to an Easter egg hunt yesterday at my church. My 1-year-old he was like 2 months old last Easter. He was little, and so he didn't really get to participate. So I was like, you know, maybe this year he'll be able to pick up some eggs or anything. He picked up one, and he was just like staring at it like he'd never seen anything like it. And so I was like trying to like help him, but they had this giant field, and there was probably thousands of eggs just in this open field. And they tried to make it really easy for like the really little kids, but it was like, as soon as they blew the whistle for kids to like go and get like their eggs, it was like Black Friday, but kids. Like people were trampling over each other. I was like, oh my gosh, these kids are crazy. It was really funny to watch. Nobody got hurt, but it was just like, it was the funniest thing. I died laughing. But I see why now they categorize the different areas by age, because those little ones would just have gotten just rammed. So yeah, he was egg-cited. That little, what is that? It's not a GIF, but that picture cracks me up. That one's one of my favorites. I think the dancing alien one is gonna take it for me though. If I'm ever in a bad mood, just put that little dancing alien up and I'll feel much better. Okay. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and do another sit. Emotes, thank you. See, I'm something. Let's just say that, I'm something. Now I'm clicking on stuff. What is going on? What am I doing? I don't even know why I touched the mouse, just to make sure that I'm scrolling correctly. That I end up messing stuff up. Okay, I'm gonna go do another set real quick. Okay. I'm dying. So naturally, what do? Add more waves. Probably gonna regret this. Only going up, what, 10 pounds? Oh, taking a nap, Yoki. Who's that? Jakey. Welcome. Thanks for the follow. What is that? GMC? GWN? Is that Gwen? GMC Gwen? Thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. And my friends, if I have anybody on YouTube, I welcome you. I can't see you guys in my chat, but if you're there, I'm thinking about you guys. All right. Okay, emotes, learning Twitch terms never ends. Trust me, yeah. Yeah, the only time I do watch a couple people on Twitch, but most of the time I'm like watching and like taking care of the kids and it's like, mommy, 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 mommy this. Look at this, mom, mom. I'm like, oh my gosh. So I do my best, but yeah. I'm a little behind on the terminology. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and do another set. My heart rate is super high right now, which is good because I can't really do cardio accelerations normally. Like I said, this time of year, I'd be doing cardio accelerations in between my sets. And that's just like, I'll do like 45 seconds of jump rope, or I'll hop on the bike or do like squat jumps or, you know, whatever. But I can't really do that because I have to keep up with the chat and, you know, I will look for any excuse not to do cardio accelerations. They're rough, I'm not gonna lie. But I mean, when you're in the fall, when you're trying to shred the weight, typically, at least for what I do, I do lighter weight. So that part it's mentally easier for weight wise, but mentally for cardio, it's not that easy. But it works really well, actually. What is that? Jimbo Dragons. That reminds me of like the Frodo Baggins, but like just slightly different. I'm a nerd. I literally just, I see all the nerdy things. I love it. I saw somebody wearing a Galaxy Quest shirt yesterday and I almost died. I was like, I need that shirt. But did I miss your response to my last question? No, let me see. Sorry, I must have not seen it. Let's see. The King of Velcro. Awesome. Would I use lots of things that are Velcro? Not as much as my kids. They have like everything, all their clothes and shoes are Velcro. Not me, not so much. But some of my, most, I'd say my gym equipment, a lot of the stuff, like the, a lot of the stuff I have for gym equipment is Velcro. You really do have a thing for Velcro, don't you? You are the king of Velcro. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and do another set real quick. That set sucked, as you can see. Having a hard time recovering after that. The King of Velcro, why are you sorry? Okay, so as far as I know, both my clients that I had scheduled to come to class today both canceled, so I should be able to stream a little longer today. We'll see. If I get a knock at the door, I'm going to have to split. But pretty sure I don't have anybody coming today. Where do we go? I'm sorry if I talk too much about Velcro. I mean, I would expect nothing less. Your name is the King of Velcro, so I would expect nothing less. We got Marky Mark. Are you back? I can try and get one of my dogs out here. We'll see. My child might try and follow. Might try and follow him. I'll come in for the clients instead. Yeah. Yeah. Heck, some of these girls, man. I had one girl who was, or I guess she's not a girl, she's a woman. But she's kind of lifted and stuff, I think, her whole life, but not super heavyweight. With me, she was lifting with me for like 3 or 4 months. And she caught me in weight, and I was amazed. Some of the stuff, the numbers she was putting up as fast as she did, it's incredible. These girls are here to work. I have three dogs. I have a German Shepherd Husky mix, and she's the one that doesn't like people. I tried to have her come out here last time, and she growled at me when I walked in. Because remember, I said I think she thinks I have a client in here because she can hear me talking. So I don't know if I can get her in. But the other one is a shepherd mix with, I think she's mixed with a smaller dog, but I'm not entirely sure what exactly she is. She's the lazy one. Yeah, she is kind of lazy. Yeah, the shepherd mix, she's super friendly. And then my little wiener dog pug mix. He's super friendly too, but he barks like nonstop for like 2 minutes at you, and then he's like your best friend, and he'll cuddle with you and all that. So yeah, Charlie, my Shepherd Husky mix, is the one that hates people. She loves me though, so I guess that's all that matters. I'll be right back. I'll try and see if I can get one of them out. Hey, Penn, you wanna come out? Gonna come out too? All three of you? Oh, look at that. Can you guys see them? Okay. Puppies! See, Pickles is my wiener dog pug. This one's Penny. She's my German Shepherd mix. And Charlie. This one's Charlie. She's my Husky Shepherd mix. Hi, baby. I'm glad you came out. I'm gonna have all the dog hair in here. My puppies, my sweet puppies. All right, come on, let's go inside. Yeah, they're super sweet. What is that, Zeeshan? Thank you for the follow. What is that, Ron? LML2, thanks for the follow. Appreciate you guys. Charlie humps things. No, she actually doesn't. The one who does is Pickles, the wiener dog pug mix. That guy, nonstop. If there was another dog around, like, nonstop. It was bad. But the other two, both the shepherds are female. And, I mean, they don't really do that, but Pickles does. Yes, I have a pug named Pickles. That was my lifelong goal when I was a kid. I was obsessed with pugs. And, So I had to get one. He's a mix, but I think we're probably going to end up with four dogs. So I really want a full bred. Yes, he is fixed. We just had that done not that long ago. We were hoping, because he was kind of aggressive too, because he's half Dachshund. And their breeds are just like, they're just a little bit aggressive. But we hoped that that would help calm him down a little bit, which it did. But he also just kind of got fat after that. So he's a little chunk now. He's a little sausage. He's cute though. Even though. Yep. I'm going to find all the equipment with Velcro and make it into a video and tag you. I need to write down the name. What is it? What was your TikTok name? Oh yeah. I need to write it down before I lose it. Oh, that's great. Okay. I got that. Pickles. Yeah. I want to get a full bred pug female and name her Peaches, and I'm going to call her Princess Peach. Which dog is the leader of the pack? Okay, so we have kind of a weird dynamic with our dogs. Pickles, the smallest dog, picks on the biggest dog, Charlie, but then Charlie picks on Penny and Penny picks on Pickles. So it's like a weird circle of checks and balances. It's the weirdest thing. So I wouldn't say any of them are really like top dog. So yeah, it's kind of weird. Usually that, I mean, dogs are really like pack animals too. And no, so that's messed up. Yeah. All right, I'm gonna go do another set. I think this is my last set of these. Oh. All right. Oh wait, no, I start with this side. Here we go. Oh man. Holy cow. That hurt. Whew. Thank God those are over. I think I say that about every workout. We got next. Two balls. yeah. We need this one.
Or actually, gonna need small weights.
Sorry, it takes me a second for cables. I'll be right there. Okay, so I'm doing kickbacks on the bench today. E-Border 2020. Thanks for the follow. What is that? McCorn. Oh gosh, I'm so sorry I'm butchering your name, but thank you for the follow. And that is at Azimaranga. Thank you for the follow. I appreciate it, guys. So, you said you're new here. Big fan of Twitch. Fitness community. Stop by and say hi.
Hi.
Sweet garage gym. Yeah, I absolutely love it. Super happy with it. Man. Let's see the fit. If you like the fit. Can you guys see? Actually, oop. I haven't figured out the camera yet. Got a white sports bra underneath. Yeah. I love it. I like bright colors, especially summer and the fall. I like all summer, spring. Honestly, I just like color. I like all the sparkles. The pink-orange combination is probably one of my favorites. Or like everything blacked out. Girl, we need some Nightbot commands. I don't know what that is. I'm sorry. I need some help with that. Nostradamus. I'll add some tonight for you guys. Thank you, Nostradamus. You're awesome. May I ask where you're from? Originally, I am from Southern California. I left California when I was about 18. Or 19, I think I might have been 19 actually. I got a scholarship to in Missouri, St. Louis, Missouri area for track. And then I met my husband. I ran track with his best friends and I met him while he was visiting his friends there. And he was in the military, so we ended up getting married a few years later, and I moved with him. We were in South Carolina, so I've been in California is where I was kind of born and raised, and then I was in Missouri for a few years. We were in South Carolina for a few years, and now I am in Tennessee, and I absolutely love it here. So happy to be here. I do miss California once in a while. I miss the beaches and In-N-Out Burger, and I miss, obviously, like, friends, and we still have a little bit of family back there. But most of my family actually ended up moving out here, too. So, yeah, I'm a Cali girl. Cali girl. So, and what got me into fitness? I started playing sports when I was really young, and and coffee bean, you're right, and Nostradamus. I think I missed that the most. But, I got into sports when I was really young, and I loved it. Like, it was such an outlet for me. Every time I was, like, mad or pissed off or felt anxious, anxiety runs in our family a little bit. So sports just made me feel normal, I guess. And I really loved it, and I was passionate about it. And once I stopped being an athlete, I got super into lifting. I was really into lifting when I was training for the heptathlon, and I just kind of carried that over when I stopped competing, just because I enjoyed it so much. And like I said, it just makes me feel so much better in every way, like mentally, physically. It helps with my self-esteem. I mean, I love it. Everything about it is great. I ran track. Yes. E-boarder, I ran track. I did the heptathlon. I just got done with powerlifting program. Oh, that's cool. What? Which program was it? And did you like it? Curious to hear about it. Gonna take the next few weeks to work on my way back into running. Yeah, if you're gonna run any time of year, right now's the time. Okay. The next one I have set up is... The next thing I have set up is going to be cable kickbacks. I'm going to do this on a flat bench. I feel like I can get more range of motion on this one. I do a variety. Sometimes I'll do standing kickbacks. I'll do like an incline bench kickback. So, and I even do some kneeling too. So I'm sure at some point you'll see me do all the different variations. I just looked at the In-N-Out plant. I know, I saw that in 2026. So that's, I think that's when like the distribution center, Marky Mark, the distribution centers and stuff are supposed to be here in 2026. But I don't know if that necessarily means that we're gonna start seeing In-N-Outs in 2026 or not. But that means that they're close to being here, which I'm ecstatic about. Like, I told my husband a couple times, I'm like, can we just go to Vegas like once or twice a year just to go like get In-N-Out? Like, we don't have to stay there. Like, can we just go for one night and get In-N-Out both days and then, spend one day there and come back? It wasn't even that I wanted to go to Vegas. It was because I wanted In-N-Out Burger. So I heard the ones in Texas are just kind of all right. So... I know the one in Vegas is amazing because I've had it so many times. But yeah. So I'm hoping that the ones that come out here are really good. And I will be there. If there's one that opens up anywhere near me, I'll probably have a heart attack. I'll be so excited. So let's see. I did the program Tuesday. Heck yeah. Isn't it so nice when you do like the mock meets and you actually like PR? I think the adrenaline and being nervous and stuff really helps with getting those couple extra pounds. Finally hit a 1,000-pound goal. Is that like the 1,000-pound club? Oh yeah, yeah. Combining squat, bench, and deadlift. Heck yeah, that's great. Yeah, that's not easy. The 1,000-pound club is not easy to make. So that's great. Heck yeah. What is that? Double FF83. Thank you so much for the follow. Okay, I'm gonna go do a set of these kickbacks. I will be back in a jiff. right. And the goal with this is to not get whacked in the face. Okay. Ooh, man.
Tico.
Holy cow. Definitely feeling those. I did not intentionally write single leg everything today. But, yeah, I didn't realize I did that until I started. I was like, oh my gosh, I think every single workout is single leg. Oh, my battery. Low power mode. Is it gonna let me? Probably not. Okay, well, what do I have next? Okay. My iPad is dying. So, my workout's probably gonna fall off the screen here in a minute. Barking Spider. I love that name. That's super funny. Thank you for the follow. Welcome in. Hi, friends out there. I love you guys. Thank you so much for the support. Okay, what is that? Luayev on Kick? I'm probably not saying that right, but thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate you. Okay, let's see. Yes, for sure. Mentally to... Yeah, whenever I e-border, whenever I feel like that, I'll do like an active recovery day where I do like a lot of plyometric stuff, and the plyometrics are still pretty challenging, but it's like you recover quickly from them, so it's not like the next day you're gonna be sore really from them, but yeah, I really like doing the plyos. I'll break it up like midweek. I'll do it. I'll have like two heavier lifting days, do a plyo workout midweek, and then finish off with the two heavier days. Shoulder press and butt squeeze. Cardio. Push-ups, sit-ups. Next, almost done. Is that what you're doing, Barking Spider? Do you compete in anything now? I don't. I was training for the bikini bodybuilding for a few years there. And then COVID hit like right before the season. And then right after that, I ended up getting pregnant and we had another baby. And my child is still pretty young too. So it's just a big commitment and I don't have really the time to do that right now. But I really do miss competing in something. I think I would really like that. Whenever I feel like competitive, sometimes I'll hop into like my husband's CrossFit classes, and they have like open workouts sometimes that I'll try and jump in to. But I'm not like a CrossFitter, so some of the movements I've never really done before, like toes to bar. I mean, I know how to do a lot of Olympic lifts and all that stuff, so I can do most of it. But like, there was one I could do every workout except toes to bar. I didn't know how to do that. I didn't know how to do the movement. So I ended up not being able to compete because of that. So, yeah, it's kind of, I would like to compete. I'm definitely have that competitive spirit. But we'll see. We'll see what happens. I might compete in something eventually. Get the babies a little older. Hello. Hello, Barking Spider. You have a charging cable that is long enough? No. I had to unplug it to, I have these lights that I had to plug in because the lighting in here is really bad. got garage lighting, so yeah, I had to unplug it, but I'm almost done. I don't have too much left, and if I forget, I have it on my phone too, so it'll be fine. Let's see. Okay, I'm gonna go do another set real quick. My son's room is right upstairs, and it sounds like there's like some WWE body slamming going on up there. I'm like kind of scared to go up and see what all the destruction that he's doing up there after this. Be fun. Yeah, 4-year-old boys are wild. It got me going. I'm still a big fan of it despite some of the negative reviews of it. Yeah, e-board or CrossFit is expensive, but if you want the like hardest workout for like, if you have to like, if you only have an hour, like if you're a really busy person, it's really good. Kicks your butt, definitely, for that whole hour you're dying, which is really good if you only have an hour. I have the luxury of working out with you guys for like 2 or 3 hours. So I don't really need to. And I'm very specific on the way I want my body to look now. I was an athlete for so long, and I just looked like thick, I guess is the best way to put it. I was kind of like husky looking. So, which I was very strong and I was very athletic, and that's what my body needed to be at the time. But now that I'm not an athlete and I don't need to be strong necessarily and explosive or any of that stuff, I'm still strong doing the bodybuilding that I'm doing now, but it's not, I can be more specific. And right now just doing the making light weights feel heavy kind of deal. It works really well. Focusing on time under tension, doing isolated movements, really focusing on specific muscles that I want to grow and other ones that I want to keep small. Like, I don't want to have giant biceps, but I also do want some definition in my biceps, so I can do specific workouts do that. What is that? Chanjo banana? I feel like there just needs to be a whole bunch of clips of me trying to pronounce people's usernames and just like make it a long reel of me embarrassing myself. But I see you on Kick. Thank you so much for the follow. Oh gosh. Okay. That kid life is no joke. It's not. I have 3 boys and they all want their own individual attention, of course. And they're all at different points in their life. I got a baby, a 4-year-old, and an almost 10-year-old. And the 10-year-old wants to play sports and read books. And my 4-year-old just wants me to play catch with him. And he loves puzzles, so he likes doing puzzles. I'll do puzzles with him. And my 1-year-old just wants to try and eat everything. And he goes after the plants in our house and tries to eat the soil out of our planters. And so I have to watch him like very closely right now. He likes chewing on dog toys. So yeah, it's fun. Nostradamus. Heck yeah. You're killing CrossFit, Nostradamus. The traditional bodybuilding workouts for 10 years. Yeah. Yeah. CrossFit is definitely a good fit for you, Nostradamus. And it gets you out of the house, which is what you need for sure. You're so social. I love CrossFit. Yeah, it's nice to switch it up. I was doing like the whole gym thing. I mean, finding a good workout partner is like impossible. I had so many workout partners that were, they just wanted to talk the whole time. And that's fine. I love the social aspect of it, but going to like a traditional gym, we would get caught up by people and they were honestly probably really lonely and just wanted someone to talk to. So we talked to them, but it would be like, I'd be like just getting a pump and then we would have somebody come and talk to us for like half an hour. And it just, I wish I could just tell them like, hey, can we talk after we're done working out? Like, can you just stick around? We'll talk to you as long as you want after. And so it was just hard. And then like trying to like schedule, trying to work out at the same time. And when people have kids, it's just like hard to get there at the same time. You don't want to, you guys have different goals. I mean, it's just finding a workout partner is hard. And going to a traditional gym was really hard for me because I just kept getting stopped. And I was there for 2 hours and only getting like two or three workouts in. So it just didn't work for me. I was worried that being in a home gym, I would get lonely. I wouldn't be as motivated because I don't have like a accountability partner. But now that I'm streaming, it's like I can talk to you guys this whole time. And so it kind of fulfills that lonely feeling that I get sometimes. And having to stream every day is keeping me accountable. So I this is honestly the best thing that could have happened for me. And I hope that you guys enjoy it too. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and do another set. Wait, what do we got over here? Sorry, I'm not watching this one. And I just saw that you have ankle straps that have Velcro. I sure do. I have two sets of ankle straps that have Velcro. Has chat gone from kick to or just haven't looked yet? Yeah, I'm sorry. I hadn't looked over there in just a second. I don't think she can see kick chat. No, I can. I forgot to check it. I'm so sorry. The kick chat should still work. That was my bad. I'm so sorry. Daniel. So sorry. I'm so sorry. Okay, let's go. What do we got? Oh, CrossFit. Is a person's fitness journey. Keep that up. I got 2-year-old. Yep. I have my 4-year-old loves being outside. So I mean, that's really good for me because the inside of the house doesn't get totally destroyed, which is nice. And my 10-year-old likes to play Fortnite, of course. So he stays pretty occupied and doesn't make too big of a mess. So it's like whenever I come in from streaming, most of the time my house isn't look like it got hit by a tornado, but sometimes it does. Girl, you got 3 kids. That home gym is probably quiet time compared. Yeah, it is. Yep, I got 3 babies. Not so much babies anymore, but one of them is. I got 1 baby and we're adopting one in the future. Are you also on Kick double stream? Yeah, I'm technically on YouTube right now too, but my stream, the chat for YouTube doesn't pull up, so I can't see if anybody's commenting anything on YouTube. It's not showing up, so can't do anything about that right now, but I do have Kicks pulled up, so I can see that too. Limitless is live on Twitch, YouTube, Kick, and hopefully TikTok soon. Yes. All right, I'm gonna go do another set real quick. I don't know if you guys can hear my dogs barking, but I guarantee you that the UPS guy is here. They hate him. He's got squeaky brakes on his truck too, so they can hear him coming from like a mile away. Oh, I lost count. I think we'll say that's 6. Probably just have time for three of those today since I'm being a little chatty Cathy. Okay. My defense mechanism, so I don't have to return to my next set as fast. Okay. All right, let's give this one a go. There we go. Okay. All right. I'll be right there. Okay. All right. No, that's fine. I'll just send it. Yeah. Hey, can you guys see me? Can you hear me? Okay, so I have a client here, so I'm going to